Davis passing, I can block initially, and then I redirect on that tricep, but then as he tries to square up with me, I wrap his head and I block this shoulder. Now I block his knee, get my foot close, heel to butt, bridge over, and then we can get the choke there. Or for you, this is perfect. I bring the knee over high, flip, and I have an arm lock.
Oh yeah, that would be good. That would be real decisive, Stu.
But let's just work on these two. Number one, where you grab the lapel. Number two, you grab the hand. Okay. Now my body is angled so that my hip pushes his head forward, right? So the block is my hand, and what moves is my body over top, right? So that's the block and the push. Okay. Now, let's look at them. We tip him over again. And we get our hand in. If I bring him all the way on top of me, this is not good. He's pinning me, right? And I don't want to go all the way over to the other side. I just want to tip him a little bit, okay? And most judo players will want to go back. They want to go back, right? They want to go back, which helps you. You can also help them. So if I'm here and I flip, I can also kick with that leg to help him, and then go into, and then go into. Okay, so let me show this. So we're here. I flip. I pull him in. If I need to, I can lift him to help. I can grab that hand and then just walk around. Walk around. No problem. Okay. So number one. Grab the lapel. Number two, grab the hand. Lift it up, put it back, boom. Yeah, he puts it in front, good. I need to move, because right now we are across from each other. We need to get in line. I need to get my legs here. Then I can take him over. Come up into position. He won't let go with the belt. I step over, I attack his wrist. Oh, he lets go. Then we go in. Okay. Last technique, then we'll do some questions.